Hi, this is Andrew at 20i. Today we're going to be looking at how we enable SSH on a hosting package here and then connect to it via a Mac OS based device. So, enabling SSH isn't too difficult. All we need to really be concerned about is generating a public key on the Mac OS based device. So firstly, we just want to go to Manage Hosting, and then we want to manage the package that we wish to do this for. Once we've done so, we then just want to scroll down, and then under Security, we should be able to see SSH access. Once we've clicked that, we should then be able to see a page, SSH access, and then we should be prompted to add a new public key. The public key is generated on the Mac OS-based device. As mentioned at the start of the video, this isn't too tricky, but if you haven't done it before, it might be slightly intimidating. In order to go about doing this, we need to use a program called Terminal. Terminal can be found by going to the launchpad or entering, pressing Command Space on your keyboard and entering Terminal. Here, we're just going to go to launchpad, and then we'll type in Terminal. Once we've done that, you should then see a window like this. Generating a public key isn't too difficult. All we need to do is enter a command. The command in question is SSH keygen. So here we need to type in SSH-keygen. Once we've done that, we then just want to hit enter. This will then prompt us for a location in which we wish to save the public and private key that we're generating. For this video, we just want to keep that as the default, so all we want to do here is hit enter. It will then prompt us for a passphrase. You can enter a passphrase if you wish to do so. For security reasons, it's beneficial. It just means that when you're connecting via SSH, you'll then be prompted for a passphrase. For this video, we're not going to enter a passphrase, but if you do enter one, when you connect via SSH later on in the video, you'll just be prompted for that passphrase. So we just hit enter there, and then we hit enter again. Once we've done that, it should then say that our key has been generated. As you can see here, it's saying that the public key that we need specifically has been generated to public has been generated to users 20i.ssh id underscore rsa.pub. So all we need to do here, we just need to copy this, and then we need to output that file so we can actually get the key. So all we want to do is cat, and then once we've done that, we just then paste, and then if you hit enter, that should then output the contents of that file. So as you can see here, this is the key, SSH RSA, and then down to where it says local, or whatever the host name of your MacBook is, or a Mac OS based device. So now that we have the key, the public key specifically, all we want to do is copy that, and then we need to go back to the my.20i control panel. So we just need to go here, and as I say, now that we have the key, we just want to paste that into the box there. Once entered, it should give you a handle, that's just determined by that at the bottom there, and the rest should be the key. Once that's been entered, simply hit Add Public Key. If that's successful, you should see the following message in the top right-hand corner of the screen saying that the SSH key has been added successfully. Once you get that, as the page notes, it says that it may take up to 5 minutes for SSH access to be processed. However, this should usually be instantaneous. So if we want to go ahead and connect now, all we need to do is enter the following into a terminal window preceded by the SSH command. So copy this, and we want to go back to the terminal window that we just had open. So go back to terminal, and from this point, to connect via SSH, simply enter SSH, and then paste that which we just copied on the SSH access page. So for me, this would be SSH, and we're SSHing as the user 20isupport.com, so just the name of the package, to the ssh.stackcp.com server. So this is just ssh20isupport.com at ssh.stackcp.com. Once we're happy, hit enter. We should then be prompted with the following. Simply enter the word yes. And then once we've done that, we should then see that we've successfully connected to the SSH server, as we can see here. And we are then free to use SSH access to manage files, directories, etc. on the package. For example, we can then see the directories and files that are in that particular folder that we're SSH to. SSH access is useful for a number of reasons, but it essentially just gives you more freedom in terms of managing your files and directories on a hosting package. We hope this has been helpful. If you have any issues or any questions, please do get in touch with our support team.